one of Matt Cameron's favorite Soundgarden songs, Christi. This is a Down on the Upside outtake recorded in 1995 for the following year's release. Its mix wasn't actually finished until 2014, however, when it was released on the compilation Echo of Miles, Scattered Tracks Across the Path, after Adam Kasper had worked on it, just as he previously did for Down on the Upside. Kim Thayil has since repeatedly expressed regret over this being cut from the album, stating that he and Chris Cornell got frustrated with some of the guitar and vocal tracking, which is precisely why the mix wasn't finished until so late, and Ben Shepherd really wanted it to be on the record as well. Kim went on to say that this song probably is stronger than a few of those that actually did make the album. To me, this is exhibit million something of the kidney stones that Soundgarden have pissed out, being better than what other bands make their flagship songs. Now, interestingly, there was a live performance of the song in 1995 during Reading Festival. And since then, fans have been sharing this online. This is video footage, not just audio. Back in the day, the song was shared with a different spelling, with C-H-R-I-S-T and then I or Y, Christy. And rumor was that the band wrote the song, or at least named it, somewhat facetiously after a stripper they had met on tour. However, do imagine my reaction when the song finally is released on Echo of Miles with that spelling. Let's just say the plot has thickened substantially. The time signature I find to fit nicely as 6-8 in the intro and verses, which especially follows the guitars. Then 12-8 in the choruses, which feel more drawn out. But ultimately, this is to the same effect. It really doesn't matter whether you count it in 6 or 12. Admittedly, I initially had very slowly counted it in 3-4 though, because I'm stupid. For most of the song, Chris and Kim are going to be playing together, starting with the same riff in the opening verse, which you can view as the intro until the vocals join. There will also be some lead effects overlaid. The guitars then split to play different variations in the chorus. Both these guitar tracks keep playing in the background as Kim's lead track takes over for his two consecutive solos. The final verse and outro are two variants played within octaves. In regards to the tuning and voicings or placements, this aforementioned live performance from Reading ended up being a great visual cue for me. From a studio version, my first intuition was that the low E string would be dropped 2 whole notes to C. From Reading Festival, it briefly looks like Chris is playing power chords for the intro and verse riff. So as a consequence, the A string also would have needed to be dropped to G, which would leave us in C, G, D, G, B, E, most likely. Soundgarden do have a lot of songs tuned similarly, so I compared. Starting with C, G, D, G, G, E from Blood on the Valley Floor. Then C, G, C, G, G, E from Burden in My Hand, Head Down, Jump into the Fire, Never the Machine Forever, Pretty News, and A Thousand Days Before, for example. Also, C, F, C, G, B, E from 4th of July. And the band just called this drop C, F, C tuning because the lowest three strings are dropped and the rest isn't. It's obvious to me from just taking a glance that the song is in neither of these tunings. And if so, that might drop CGC tuning to go with that naming convention would have been most likely. But even from this mid-90s potato quality VHS, I was able to confirm the tuning and chord voicings I had already written out from isolating Chris's and Kim's guitar tracks. The slower octave so present in the recording is the bass, not the guitars. Remember that a bass guitar is tuned an octave below an electric guitar. The thickness of the guitar is achieved by Chris and Kim playing together, the same parts. The lowest pitch note from these guitars is a D2, not a C2. Thus, the tuning is actually just drop D. Therefore, only the low E string is detuned, going down a whole step to D. A, D, G, B, E. The song opens with the intro leading into the first verse. This is two guitars played by Chris and Kim together. We begin by plucking the 3rd fret on the A string once, and then follow this by plucking the 5th fret fast together thrice, and stopping the string from ringing out at the end of the bar. The note does not bleed into the next one. So you can play this down, up, stroke, or down, down, up, down, stroke. Whatever is more fluid for you. Either way, this was the first bar, which we're now going to be repeating 23 times. The vocals join during the 9th bar of this at 22 seconds. You can see that I abbreviated this for my demonstration into 4 bars, because why would I be sitting here playing it 24 times? Let's now play through this abbreviated demo slowly together. Simultaneously, there's going to be an overlay coming from a lead guitar. For which we'll be utilizing tremolo picking, meaning every downstroke is followed by an upstroke and vice versa. Starting on the 11th fret of a G string, which we're going to be playing like this, roughly 5 times. Then the 13th, also roughly 5 times. Then the 15th, also roughly 5 times. Then we'll be moving back down to the 11th fret, which we'll be playing roughly 3 times. Play it once more to slide it down to the 10th. Play this once. Play it again to slide it down to the 9th. Play this once. Play it again to slide it down to the 8th. Play this twice. Play it a 3rd time to slide it down to the 7th. Play it again to slide it down to the 6th. Play this to slide it down to the 5th. And play this to slide it down to the 4th. Thank you. Simultaneously, there's going to be another overlay from a second lead guitar. We can use a whammy or a wah pedal to get this kind of sound. And we're again using all tremolo picking here. The pedal can just be continuously moved up and down. There's nothing special to take note of here. We begin on the 19th fret of the E string. And then we follow this with the 21st. Which we'll keep playing for a while. And the last one with a quarter bend and stopping the string. So this is a very slight pitch increase. We're not even moving up to that of a 22nd fret. This rests for a moment before picking back up again with tremolo picking on the 21st fret of the high D string, back to the 19th fret E, and the 21st fret, which we keep playing for a while, and then stopping the string. At 1:03, we'll be in the first chorus. This is where Chris and Kim are going to be splitting off into separate guitar parts. We'll start with Chris's part. You can see that we play a variation of what we've learned for the intro and verse. We'll again be plucking the 3rd fret on the A once, followed by the 5th fret thrice, but we'll also be adding in for each of these plucks, or I should better say strums, the open low D string. So our first strum is going to be a D/C chord, which is not a triad, so not really a chord, thus slash chord. Followed by a D/D. Then we'll be moving down to plucking the 4th fret on the low D string with a half bend and release the bend again. So we're trying to meet the pitch of the 5th fret. Bring it back down to that of the 4th, then pluck the 3rd. 2nd, 1st, and the open string. That's one bar, which we're going to be repeating 3 times now, to play it 4 times in total. Simultaneously, Kim is going to be playing a variation of this. for first buffers, Kim is playing exactly what we've already learned for Chris's part. Then for the second, third and fourth bars is where he's playing a variation. He's essentially arpeggiating a D5 chord, for which we pluck the 7th fret on the high D string, followed by the 5th fret on the A, and then as a ghost note at lower volume, pluck this 5th fret again. It's really just hinted at in the recording. The rest of the bar moves down to the low D string again, where it repeats. As we've already learned, repeat the 2nd bar twice now. And from the aforementioned Reading performance is where I was able to verify that Kim did in fact arpeggiate this D5 chord up here in a bar shape, rather than doing so in the open shape for, say, economy of movement, which Soundgarden did not give any regard to whatsoever. So compare this. This is terrible to play or anything, but I'm pointing this out so you understand my rationale for moving it up here rather than down here. At 1 minute 23 seconds, we'll be in what I notated as the post-chorus, where Chris and Kim are going to be playing together, really just repeating the intro and first verse that we've learned for 4 bars. Then we'll be in the next verse, where Chris and Kim are again playing together, this time a variation. So here we are beginning the bar by repeating what we've learned for the intro and first verse, and then add in 2 additional notes towards the end of the bar, which is the 4th fret on the low D string, bent up a half step and released, like we already know from the chorus, and then pluck the 3rd fret with vibrato. Now, rather than in the chorus, don't go down to the 2nd and then the 1st fret and then the open strings. This is the end of the bar already, which we're going to be repeating 19 times to play 20 times in total. Again, I abbreviated this into 4 for the demonstration. Then we'll be in the next chorus, where Chris is repeating, for 6 bars. And simultaneously, Kim is going to be playing the slightest variation of what he played in the previous chorus. Thank you. So that's the same idea for the second chorus as it was for the first one. And that will again apply for the third one. The first bar of Kim's guitar is going to always repeat what Chris is playing. The second bar is always going to be where he will be introducing the arpeggiated D5 chord. The only difference between the variations is going to be in ghost note placement. So rather than playing through the entire chorus bit slowly every time, I think it will be more fruitful to point this out right here and refer to the demonstration and the explanation, so that we're gonna save a little bit of time in this video lesson. The first bar of this again is going to be repeating. For the second bar, the arpeggiated D5 comes back in again, but now with all three notes that we've previously learned, the 7th fret on the high D, followed by two plucks of the 5th fret on the A, as ghost notes at lower volume, before returning to full volume to finish the bar. That's the second bar. The third is going to be an exact repetition of this one. And then the fourth, fifth, and sixth bars are going to be arpeggiating this D5 at full volume, just like the rest of the notes following it. After this, there's going to be a minor detail happening at 2 minutes 56 seconds. This is a lead overlay from a clean guitar without distortion, and all it's doing is playing the 16th fret on the E string and quickly followed by the 17th. I play this with a down and an up stroke. Which will lead us at 2 minutes 57 seconds into the first guitar solo. This begins with a pluck of the open high D string, which we let ring out. Then we'll play the 10th fret on the B, followed by the 13th. We'll let this ring out even longer, before slowly plucking the open high D string three times. Then the 11th fret on the G, after a moment, the 12th fret on the B, 13th, 12th, and 11th fret G. I'm keeping my fingers in position here because I'll next be playing a ghost note on this 12th fret of the B, at lower volume, before returning to full volume on the 11th fret G, and then the 12th fret high D. Let the string out, and then pluck twice, slowly, as ghost notes. To let the string out. After a moment, we're back to full volume, on the 10th fret of a B. After a moment, back to the 12th fret on the high D, which will pluck four times slowly as ghost notes. Back to full volume for plucking the 15th fret on the B. Immediately followed by two ghost notes on the G, on the 10th and 11th frets. Back to full volume, plucking the 12th fret on the high D. And now, follow this with 5 more plugs. I'm using all downstrokes for this, which we play fast together. Then, also fast, the 14th fret on the G twice. Again fast, the 14th fret on the high D thrice. Followed by a ghost note on the 12th fret. Back to full volume, the 11th fret on the G twice. 12, 11th twice. 12th fret high D, 11th fret G. Follow this by 5 more plucks of this 11th fret. Twelfth fret high D, 10th fret G, which we after a moment slide down to the 7th. And now, without plucking any strings, we're just going to be sliding the fingers that we place across the strings up the neck. In the background of this, both rhythm guitar parts are going to keep playing. With Chris's guitar, so the first 4 bars of this are going to be a repetition of his chorus riff. Then the 5th and final bar is going to be a variation of a longer verse riff with the additional notes at the end. Only this time, we are, rather than just plucking the 3rd fret on the A, followed by the 5th fret 3 times, retaining, strumming this together with the open low D string. Then we're going to be bending the 4th fret on the low D string with a half step and release it. Follow it by plucking the 3rd fret. And immediately follow this by plucking the 3rd fret on the A. Followed by the 5th fret thrice. And stopping it. No need to be slowing down the chorus riff here again, so let's take a look at the 5th bar slowed down. Once more, Kim is going to be playing a variation here. He DOTU is going to be repeating a chorus variation, beginning with arpeggiating the D5 chord in the first part full volume. Then for the second, third and fourth bars, arpeggiating this D5 chord as ghost notes before returning to full volume. And then for the fifth and final bar, he again is going to be arpeggiating this D5 chord as ghost notes before returning to full volume and playing exactly what we learned for Chris's part. Once more, no need to be repeating all of what we've already learned here, so let's just play the last bar of this slowly. At 3 minutes 22 seconds, the second guitar solo joins. I'm decently sure Kim is using a whammy pedal in there, possibly an octave, some sort of flanger. All I have is a wah pedal and I find I can get close enough. I'm starting with a pushed all the way down as I pluck the 15th fret on the B. Then we're going to be switching to tremolo picking as we've previously learned on the 14th fret of the E. Now add in this 15th fret on the B again to play it with the 14th fret together, and this is where I start flailing the pedal up, down, up, down, up, down. Keep this going, then slide it down the neck. Make sure the pedal is pushed all the way down as we pluck the 12th fret on the high D string with a horse step. Pluck it again without any bend. Followed by the 10th fret on the G, the 10th fret on the B with a half bend, and then the 12th fret with a pinch harmonic. For a pinch harmonic, or an artificial one, as opposed to a natural one, where we'd just be laying the finger across the fret, without pressing down and producing overtones like this, we now have to get the sound by simultaneously striking the string with the plectrum, but also either a thumbnail or the pad of the thumb. And this is going to be producing the screaming-like sound. And we have to play with positioning here, because depending on location, we're getting a weaker or a stronger sound or none at all. Follow this by plucking the 14th fret and after a moment, bending up a whole step. Now pull the wah pedal all the way back and pluck the 12th fret on the A, followed by the 9th. Push the pedal all the way back down to strum together the 12th fret on the high D and the 11th fret on the G twice. Pluck the 15th fret on the B, the 12th fret on the A, the 14th, back to the 15th fret on the B, which we after a moment bend up a whole step. Pluck it again to play it with vibrato. Pluck it once more to hammer it onto the 16th fret. Play the 17th fret with a half bend. Pluck the 17th again without any bend to slide it down to the 16th and that to the 15th. Pluck the 11th fret on the G, followed by the 14th with a whole and a half bend that we then stop from ringing out. So here we are trying to meet the pitch not of the 15th, not of the 16th, but of the 17th fret. A whole and a half bend, that's a lot. Once more, the two rhythm guitars are going to keep playing in the background, and this time, Chris and Kim will be playing the same thing. So for this, we start with a longer verse riff with the two additional notes at the end that we've already learned. Repeat this three times to play it for four bars. Then we'll be continuing with a shorter element that we've learned as the intro or first verse. To repeat this for three times to play it for four bars in total. Then we'll be in the next verse. And this is where the two guitars are going to split to play within octaves of one another. Chris's guitar is going to be repeating the intro or short verse bit for 16 bars. Simultaneously, Kim's guitar part So here we are going to be playing the higher octave, but we'll also be adding in two additional notes at the end, like we already know from the lower octave version in the previous verse. For this, we begin by plucking the 5th fret on the G once, followed by the 7th fret thrice fast. Then we'll be bending up the 7th fret on the B a half step, and release was bent again. So we're trying to get it up to the pitch of this 8th. Before playing the 6th fret with vibrato. Same pattern as we've previously learned, just different location and octave. That was the first bar, which we're going to be repeating 15 times, to play it 16 times in total. Let's abbreviate this as we slow it down. Then we'll be in the next and final chorus, where Chris is going to be repeating. Eight times. Simultaneously, Kim is once more playing a variation. Which we begin by arpeggiating this D5 chord at full volume for the 7th fret on the high D and the 5th fret on the A, and then pluck this 5th fret again as a ghost note at low volume. Return to full volume for the rest of the bar. That's the first one. Repeat this one twice for the second and third bar. The fourth one starts by arpeggiating this D5 chord using all ghost notes. Returning to full volume for the rest of the bar. Then the fifth bar is going to be repetition of this fourth one. And then the sixth, seventh, and eighth bars are going to be a repetition of the first three ones, where we begin at full volume and have that one ghost note and return to full volume. What happens at 5 minutes 6 seconds, I notated as the outro. This is again going to be where Chris and Kim are going to be playing within octaves of one another, this time in a different variation. Chris's guitar is going to be repeating the intro or short verse bit for 9 bars. Simultaneously, Kim is going to be playing . So here, he again is going to be playing the higher octave, as we've already learned for the third verse, plucking the 5th fret on the G once, followed by the 7th fret thrice, and now we actually stop the string. And we're not going to be following this up with the two additional notes at the end of the bar, with the half bend release and vibrato. This is one finished bar, and this is also going to be repeated 8 times, to play it 9 times in total. And that was the final bit of a song to learn.